Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, and in today's video, we're going to talk about three tools you need to build an AR app. So unlike in smartphone applications, where we experience the app through a 2D screen, in AR, you experience it in the real world, because it's virtual objects blended into the real world. So what that means is you need 3D models to build your AR experience. There are various ways to get hold of 3D models. The most traditional way of doing it is using 3D modeling software like Blender, Maya, or ZBrush, which people have used for years to build their 3D models. But these require a steep learning curve and might take a couple of years for you to master them well enough to build anything you want from scratch. A more easier way to get 3D models is, of course, get 3D models that others have made. And there are plenty of sites available, like TurboSquid or Google Poly, which have millions of 3D models available for download. And anything you could think of, you'll probably find there. And you could just mix and match what you need to build your AR app. And these are mostly free models to use. And some of them, of course, are paid, especially the higher quality ones. But this is a route that I would highly recommend for someone who is a beginner AR developer and whose main skills are in programming. Because what you want to do is focus your time on building the app and not worrying about the art, which is essentially a different skill set. And the final way of building 3D models is to use VR to sculpt your models. Now, this is a bit less common, unconventional, and a bit less established for obvious reasons. How does this work? Well, you can see I've got a VR headset back in my shelf. And with this, I've got access to sculpting softwares like Gravity Sketch, Oculus Medium, or Google Blocks. And these essentially allow you to build your 3D models by sculpting them with your hands or your controllers. So this is a much more intuitive way of doing things, so it's much faster to learn and much more easier, which makes it attractive for beginners. But the downside is it's less customizable and it's not very functional yet. What that means is you probably could build a prototype model and you might need to port it off to the more traditional softwares like ZBrush or Blender to polish it off before it's usable in your AR experiences. But that's today. In a couple of years' time, I'm pretty sure this will become advanced enough to replace the entire 3D production pipeline. And if that happens, it's great because beginners can get into 3D modeling much quicker. So these are the various ways of building your 3D models. And out of this, the ones that I would recommend are to first use 3D models available online through sites like TurboSquid. And then if you want to build something a bit more of your own, to use VR, if you have a VR headset, to sculpt your model. So now you've got the 3D content. Next thing to do is to breathe life into that 3D world using programming. So for AR to happen, the phone, through its camera, needs to see the real world and make sense of it. It needs to understand the context, it needs to understand where objects are, like their table, your bed, your floor, your walls. It needs to understand where they are so they could realistically place virtual objects in your surroundings. So to take a simple example, if you want to place, a flower pot on your table, a virtual flower pot on your table, the phone will first understand that there's a horizontal plane, which is the table, and then once it's detected that, it will then place the virtual flower pot on it. And this requires heavy and a lot of computer vision and machine learning. And lucky for us, most of this, we don't need to build it ourselves from scratch. Instead, Apple has provided a framework called ARKit, which lets you use these out of the box. ARKit is great because it has most of the AR functionalities that you would ever need. And the latest one, ARKit 4.0, even has a location anchor feature. So what that means is, say if you want to place your AR objects into a different location, say you want to place a virtual object in the Eiffel Tower. So you can go to Apple Maps and place it there, and it would appear there for everyone using your app. So that's a pretty interesting feature that I find. So apart from ARKit, you would also need to use SceneKit. And SceneKit is Apple's take on a games engine and essentially does all the heavy lifting you need to build a 3D experience. So in summary, you would need ARKit in conjunction with SceneKit to build quality AR experiences for the Apple ecosystem. And this is more so the case if you're building productivity apps, for example, or utility apps, where you would need those native iOS components to build a polished experience. But say if you're building something more 3D intensive, or say a game, for that, this stack would not be ideal. Instead, something better to use would be Unity and Vuforia. So Unity is a very popular games engine used by the games industry to build games. and before iOS, of course, a framework which you can use with Unity to build AR experiences. So the advantage of using Unity for building games is that it is a more mature game engine platform firstly, and that means it has most of the heavy lifting done for you in terms of things like, say, collision detection or other physics that you need to build a 3D game. Secondly, most importantly, is that with Unity, with one code base, you can target multiple platforms. It's a cross-platform engine. That's not something I can do with Xcode and SceneKit and ARKit, but of course, the downside of using Unity then is that you won't get access to those native iOS components, which will be extremely useful for building things like productivity apps or utility apps. So now that you got the 3D modeling done and you used ARKit and SceneKit to build the AR experiences, it's time to move on to the third and final tool, and that is testing. Unfortunately, you can't use the simulator in Xcode to test your AR app. Instead, you would need an actual device. And what you would need is any device that has an A9 chip or higher. And this essentially means iPhone 6 and above. So these are the different things you would need to build an AR app. In summary, they were number one, 3D models. And for this, highly recommend sites like TurboSquid to get pre-made assets. And number two was ARKit and SceneKit to build AR functionality into your iOS device. And finally, testing device, which is basically any iOS device which has at least an A9 chip to test the AR app. So with these three tools, you can build any AR app that you want for the Apple ecosystem. That brings us to the end of our video today. And if you're interested in more augmented reality tutorials, do subscribe to my channel and follow. And in the next video, we'll start building our first AR app. See you then.